This is module one of the terrain analysis tutorial. We will be discussing digital elevation model pre-processing options. LiDAR data is often delivered in the form of elevation contours or as a mass point file. All terrain analysis calculations made in this exercise require a digital elevation model or DEM as a base input layer. To convert contours or spot elevations to a DEM, the topo to raster interpolation command is used. It is a robust method of conversion and allows the user to specify many different data output options. Here, a contour file is converted into a DEM. It is important to note the limits of your contour data in regards to output raster cell size when interpolating. In this instance, we are creating a 3-meter DEM from contours that represent 2 feet of vertical relief. This ensures for all but the flattest areas that several contour lines are used to interpolate the real-world elevation per cell or pixel. To generate a DEM from a contour shapefile, we utilize the topo to raster tool in the interpolation toolbox within Spatial Analyst Tools. After adding the input feature data, it is important to select the field name that contains the contour values, as well as the data type, either spot for point elevations or contours, as in this case. Other parameters of the calculation to address include output cell size, as it is often calculated for you, and drainage enforcement. Selecting Help within the Topo to Raster dialog box offers suggestions on which of these items in the drop-down menus to select. Drainage enforcement, as part of the topo to raster interpolation, is only recommended in areas with known sinks that you wish to be filled. All other parameter defaults provide acceptable results, but may be fine-tuned if a user has direct knowledge of a particular landscape. Although LiDAR data can be accurate to a 1-meter spatial resolution, here we have chosen to create a DEM with a 3-meter resolution. This preserves most of the accuracy of the original dataset, but creates a file nearly 1/10 the size of a 1-meter DEM, streamlining subsequent analyses. For most portions of Minnesota, a 3-meter DEM very accurately characterizes landscape features for terrain analysis purposes. Often, LiDAR data is acquired in the form of a DEM, with the pre-processing steps being completed by a vendor or third party. Depending on what pre-processing has been done, this raster may or may not have been screened for sinks or spurious holes in the elevation data. When creating a DEM yourself via topo to raster with enforced drainage, realize that sinks or pits have already been filled. If LiDAR data is acquired as a DEM, it is important to consider the effects of pit filling. Due to the way certain terrain attributes are calculated, closed depressions on the landscape will terminate a certain flow path, even though this may not be occurring on the ground. As it applies to terrain analysis, pit filling essentially fills a closed depression with hypothetical water and routes the outflow to the lowest elevation within the closed depression. For example, if you have a small retention pond on the landscape and try to model surface flows with terrain analysis, the flow will terminate in the pond since flow models won't route water uphill out of the pond. However, with pit filling, hypothetical water will fill the pond and the flow will continue through the lowest elevation of the pond if it were the pond's outlet. This may not always be the most accurate portrayal of surface flows on the ground, although it is a conservative approach and is recommended in many situations. For example, in areas with extensive topographic relief, large storm events often flush water from the hill slopes to a stream channel. In these areas, depressions on the surface may not be trapping water, so pit filling may create more accurate terrain attributes and is recommended. In other landscapes, such as very flat areas, large storm flows may be held in hill slope depressions to be later removed by evapotranspiration. Routing these flows downslope by pit filling may be inaccurate. This type of a landscape may not be well suited for pit filling, although as mentioned earlier, it is a more conservative approach and should be investigated. Here's an example of a historical wetland or lake bed that is extremely flat. There would be minimum surface flow in a flat area such as this, however, pit filling has forced flow paths on the surface. Note the characteristic parallel flow paths of pit filling. One would need to visit this site to confirm whether or not this area generates surface flow. Since it is possible that subsurface or artificial drainage conveys this water downslope, pit filling is used here, so predicted flow is not terminated in the depression. In this fashion, surface flows may be overestimated. However, for this type of analysis, it may be better to overestimate flow than to underestimate it. Pit filling is done by simply using the fill command in the Spatial Analyst Toolbox using hydrology tools. To investigate the results of both a filled DEM and a non-filled DEM, It is helpful to create separate workspaces for files so their resultant attributes can be stored and identified more easily. This concludes the first module of the terrain analysis tutorial.